The latest news, with very, very new information, is this radiation impact due to generation of electricity. This happened in the United Nations, really, too, following a request of my country, the other one as well, by the way, who said the following: we are calculating the radiation produced by nuclear and making a lot of noise about that. What about the other sources of energy? Why we don't study that? People sometimes say, no, but why another source? But at the end, they accepted. And a big study was launched. All the sources of energy were studied except hydro. Then I will explain why. But all of them were studied. Were studied to see how much radiation they produce. The report, which is in your web, no? It's in the web, has been just printed by ANSCEA. The report contains other information as well. I mean, the information, this is in Annex B of the report. Annex A, C, and D contain also very good information of other subjects. But B is the one contain information I will pass to you. Well, ANSCEA study all these sources: nuclear, coal, natural gas, oil and biofuel, geothermal, wind and solar. All of them were studied. Nuclear power and coal were studied in more detail because there are data. The others, they contain very little data, but extrapolation can be done. The life cycle of all were studied. For nuclear, as you know, include uranium mining, milling, operation, and reprocessing. For coal, include coal mining, the operation of coal-fired power plant, both modern and old. There's a very big, big difference between modern plant and old plant. And deposit of coal ash. The metric used was the collective dose, given the full impacting doses of the plant. You know the collective dose is the summation of all these doses due to the release of the plant, as I mentioned you before. And the collective dose over time was assessed for taking into account the releases that remain over time in populations of the future as well. Therefore, the full impact was assessed. Of radiation, we are not talking of effect, we are talking of radiation. The global public radiation impact, the first surprise was to learn that among the various sources of energy, the source that delivers the highest radiation exposure to people is not nuclear, it's coal. Coal produces more radiation to people than nuclear. What is the reason? Because coal contains radium. And when you burn coal, part of this radium goes to the atmosphere. The ashes of coal are very rich in radium. What people do with the ashes of coal? Throw it away. There is not a waste management program of coal ashes. The coal cycle contributes more than half of the total dose of the people. And the nuclear fuel contribute less than one-fifth. Big difference. For coal is high, nuclear is low as far as radiation is concerned. The contribution of coal comes primarily from radon and radium. And it's interesting that in the nuclear case, the main contribution also coming from natural nuclides, not from artificial. It's coming from mining and from natural nuclides. The great culprit, as I said, is radium, which, as I mentioned to many of you, is a very nasty radionuclide for which there is very big epidemiological incidence. These are the radium girls that I mentioned before, painting with radium and getting cancer. and radon and radon, which go to your lung and is clearly a cancerogenous, producing lung cancer. Of the remaining technologies, geothermal energy and combustion of gas were the next largest contributor. Geothermal energy probably is much bigger, but we have very few data on geothermal energy because the only country relying on that is Iceland. So there are very few data. Now, people can say, this is a big impact because people use a lot of coal. For less analyzed impact per unit of electricity produced, the same happened. If you do it per unit of electricity produced, coal is the highest, significantly higher than the other technologies. Based on this limited information, we believe that the doses from geothermal power are also very big. The few data that we have show that they are very big. Now, what happened with the workers? Well, the biggest occupational impact is from coal mining. For also coal is the main generation of occupational exposure. But the second and biggest surprise of this United Nations report is coming from the following analysis. We have analyzed how much radiation people incur when we install a given amount of power. Let's say a country decides to put 1,000 megawatts. Well, there will be radiation to get materials for 1,000 megawatts of electric, of nuclear, for coal. And the surprise was that the two sources that contribute much more are solar and wind. This was a shock, because everybody is convinced that solar and wind are fantastic for nature. This was a shock, and this is coming from the fact that both solar and wind need rare earth metals. And rare earth metals are called rare because they are very rare. And to get these metals, you have to mine so much that you produce a lot of radium and radon, which expose people. And this generates an ethical problem that I will mention. Rare earth for solars need tellurium. Tellurium is 3 times as rare as gold. Very rare, for you have to mine a lot to get this tellurium. And without tellurium, you don't have solar cells. And wind generators, yes, they also need. They need neodymium. Believe it or not, this is a metal. Very rare. Who talk about neodymium? The magnets in this turbine do not work if they don't have neodymium in all of them. And to get neodymium, you need a lot of mining operation as well. Now, the ethical problem is that in this case, it's not the same people who receive the radiation. Or I have an Austrian friend, he told me, yes, this is true. But we will continue to put windmills and solar because we don't have here mines for neodymium. We buy the neodymium from China, from Canada, and the effect is there, not on us. This is very nasty. Logic, but this is the logic that is going on. United Nations cannot do that. United Nations cannot say, no, the impact is very little because it's an impact from the Chinese, not of the rest of the world. In summary, according to the United Nations, the radiation impact, both total per unit of electricity generated, is larger to coal than to nuclear, both to the public and occupational. The largest occupational impact due to the construction of plant is in the solar power cycle, followed by the wind power cycle. This is really a shock, has been a shock in the United Nations, and still is not well known. For that reason, we have agreed here to have one of the exercises on this problem. This is a group working on this. What about accidents? Well, as I mentioned to you, in accidents, there has not been comparative assessment related to electricity generation, and SCEAR have not authority to do this. But what you have to ask is what you want to prevent. Losses of human life is your problem. In that case, the problem is coal and hydro. Coal and hydro are the killers of people in accidents. And I will show you. Or environmental consequences. Environmental consequences, gas and oil. These are the major. Or social, economic, and political impact. In that case, it's nuclear. Why I said deaths? Deaths, because the coal mines are killing thousands of people every year. Or public accident hydraulic dams. Only in China, in the Bankiao Dam, 26 people were killed in the moment, and 105,000 were then. This last year, as I said, people have to be evacuated from the Orville Dam in US. 180,000 people would have died. For killing people, dams, hydro is the worst. For environmental impact, well, look, you remember the Deep Water Horizon platform in US in 2010, a big disaster, big environmental disaster. Nuclear accidents, yes, they produce, as we said, political and economical catastrophe, Chernobyl, political, social, and economic catastrophe, Fukushima. Okay, thank you for this. You can send me questions or after in the at the end of the day, we can discuss this, because this is very important for the future of nuclear. And now I